This is your KCTV5 news update.
The city of Plattsburgh has issued a boil advisory. Right now, it's specifically for the Timber Springs and Centennial Farm subdivision in Trimble, Missouri. Residents there should boil water for at least 2 minutes before consumption. Crews found a water leak and repaired it, but water testing won't be completed until Tuesday. Members of a church damaged by Friday storms in Harrisonville are planning to hold services on Sunday. Powerful winds ripped off part of the church's roof. Members say they are still going to hold those services inside of a barn instead of their usual building. And we've learned a motorcyclist who crashed when running into debris from Friday storms is going to be okay. The crash happened in the area of North Ledge and North Drury Avenue in northeast Kansas City yesterday morning. The rider was seriously hurt, but is expected to recover. Missouri Governor Mike Parson has taken action to prevent any possible federal intervention in the right to bear arms. On Saturday, he signed a bill into law which prohibits state and local cooperation with federal officials who attempt to enforce any laws, orders, or actions to violate Second Amendment rights. Under the new measure, any person or entity found to be knowingly depriving citizens of their right to bear arms will be liable for damages of $50,000. Carl Oakman will be sworn in as Kansas City, Kansas's new police chief on Monday. He's a 29-year veteran of the Kansas City, Missouri Police Department. He served as the deputy chief of police there since 2017. Suspected serial killer Frederick Scott will be in court on Monday. Scott is charged with killing six people, including six men and a woman. The homicide started in August of 2016 and ended after Scott's arrest a year later in August of 2017. Scott's competency hearing is scheduled to begin at 1.
Good morning, I'm Bill Hurlbrink with your Sunday morning weather update. 90 degrees is where we're headed this afternoon under mostly sunny skies. The good news, less humid conditions for today and tomorrow before the humidity starts to dial itself back up midweek here in Kansas City. So dew points is how we look at the amount of water vapor and moisture in the air. If the dew points are below 55 degrees, it's very nice outside. When we get above 60 degrees, it starts to get a little bit humid out there. We're kind of borderline on that today and tomorrow, but here on Tuesday and Wednesday, we really start to dial that up into the muggy, near miserable range for your dew points. Your air temperature, on the other hand, I think will be in the 90s, low 90s today, low 90s tomorrow. Cold front comes through Monday into Tuesday, brings small chances of rain, especially to the west side of town. Tuesday, upper 80s. Wednesday, we're back into the 90s, and that's kind of where we look like we're sitting at for the next few days. Temperatures in the upper 80s, low 90s throughout this week into next weekend. Have a great day.
Turn to KCTV5 News for the latest all day. This is your personalized update because KCTV5 News stands for you.